yeah.
Thank you so much for tuning in, everybody. That was When I'm 64. It's a song by the English rock band The Beatles, written by Paul McCartney, and it was credited to Lennon McCartney. And it was released on their 1967 album, Sgt. Pepper's Lonely Hearts Club Band. It was one of the first songs written by McCartney. He wrote it when he was only 16 years old.
Our next song is Come Again, Sweet Love Doth Now Invite by John Dowland. Dowland's gift for expressive text setting is everywhere evident in these songs. Come Again, Sweet Love Doth Now Invite from the first book of songs or airs creates a crescendo of excitement in its panting refrain that renders palpable the pangs of newfound love.
To do me.
1915, during World War I, Major John McCrae, a surgeon assigned to the Canadian forces fighting near Ypres, Belgium, wrote the poem In Flanders Fields as a plea for help and reinforcements. After witnessing the death of his dear friend and the slaughter of thousands of soldiers, McCrae sat down and wrote the poem On Flanders Fields. Not only is McCrae lamenting the loss of life, but in the last verse, he is actually begging for reinforcements. McCrae believed that Britain's cause was noble and just, and that by sending in overwhelming numbers of soldiers, the war could be brought to a swift and satisfactory conclusion. By the end of the war in 1918, there would be nearly 700,000 Allied casualties at Flanders Fields. Now, only poppies grow on Flanders Fields.
Crosses row on row, mad
Sound of Silence, originally The Sounds of Silence, is a song by American music duo Simon and Garfunkel. The song was written by Paul Simon over several months in 1963 and 1964. A studio audition led the duo, signing a record deal with Columbia Records, and the original acoustic version of the song was recorded in March 1964 at Columbia Studios in New York City, and included on their debut album, Wednesday Morning, 3 a.m., released on October 19, 1964. The album was a commercial failure and led to the duo disbanding. Simon returned to England and Art Garfunkel to his studies at Columbia University.
But not all was lost. In 1965, the song began to attract airplay at radio stations in Boston, Massachusetts, and throughout Florida. The growing airplay led Tom Wilson, the song's producer, to remix the track, overdubbing electric instruments and drums. This remixed version was released as a single in September 1965. Simon and Garfunkel were not informed of the song's remix until after its release. The song hit number one on the Billboard Hot 100 for the week ending January 1st, 1966, leading the duo to reunite and hastily record their second album, which Columbia titled Sounds of Silence, in an attempt to capitalize on the song's success. The remixed single version of the song was included on this follow-up album. It was featured in the 1967 film The Graduate and was included on the film's soundtrack album. It was additionally released on the Mrs. Robinson EP in 1968, along with three other songs from the film, Mrs. Robinson, April Come She Will, and Scarborough Fair / Canticle.
Hello, darkness, my old friend. I've come to talk to you again. Because a vision softly creeping left its seeds while I was sleeping. And the vision that was planted
thank you. Our next song, The Lion Sleeps Tonight, originally titled Mbuba, which means lion in Zulu, was originally a big hit in Swaziland, selling nearly 100,000 copies in the 1940s, as sung by its originator, South African Solomon Linda. Linda had written it based on a boyhood experience chasing lions that were stalking the family's cattle, and recorded the tune in 1939 with his group, The Evening Birds. The Weavers adapted it as Wimowe in 1957 and failed to credit Linda. When the Kingston Trio released their version in 1959, they credited both The Weavers, pseudonym Paul Campbell, and Linda. Linda, meanwhile, died with only $25 in his bank account, and his heirs still are pursuing royalties from one of the best-known worldwide hits ever. Arranger Scott Turnbull Bull creates this barbershop adaptation.
Song, A Wink and a Smile, is a happy love song made its debut in the 1993 film Sleepless in Seattle, starring Tom Hanks and Meg Ryan, written by Mark Shaman and Ramsey McLean. The piece was recorded by Harry Cornick Jr. Most of the tunes that were included in the movie's soundtrack were popular during the 1940s. A Wink and a Smile attempts to capture the feel and simplicity of the music of that era.
Laughter and love songs, a table for two.
Thank you, everybody, for being here with us. We can feel your presence, and we should probably be able to find this recording later on the YouTube channel that you're watching from now. Have a good evening.